Hello everybody, my name is Naír Carrera, I'm the coordinator of this course. Very warm welcome to all of you who have decided to join us in this course to start this great adventure with us. We really hope that you will be learning a lot together with us, and we're looking forward to seeing you in the course. So in this tutorial, we're gonna talk a bit about the website of Code Week. More specifically, I'm gonna guide you through the website for schools that we have specifically designed for teachers like you, in order to help you get started in Code Week and in order to provide you with some interesting tools and resources to help you implement coding in your classroom. So the first thing that you will need to do in order to go to the website of CodeWeek is just go to codeweek.eu, which is the official website of the campaign. You will be landing in this page over here, and you will see that here in the upper part of the screen you have the sign-in option, where you will need to sign in to create an account if you're not there yet. You will get to choose your preferred method to sign in. It's either GitHub, Twitter, Facebook, or Google. Or if you already have an account, which I hope is the case for most of you, you will be putting just your email address here, password, and click on login. And once you are registered, you will be able to see your name in the upper part of the screen. And also from here, you will be able to access your events, your certificates. You will be able also to report your events and also to log out. And once you are registered, you will be landing in this page, where the most striking thing that you will be seeing is this counter, which tells us how many days, hours, minutes, and seconds are left in order to reach the peak of the campaign. So make sure you prepare yourself and register an activity before it actually starts. So the first thing that you will find here is the activities tab in the upper part of the screen, where you will be able to see actually how many activities are being organized in your countries. You can also zoom in and zoom out in order to get a better insight of those as well. And if you want to see which countries are buzzing with coding activities, then you can go to the scoreboard here in the upper part of the screen, in the right side of the screen, and you will be able to find out. Please consider that this scoreboard is sorted by the number of listed coding activities per population, so don't be surprised if some of the smaller countries higher up on the list. So next to the activities tab, you will find the ambassadors tab, where you will be able to find the different ambassadors, these great volunteers who are doing very nice work and have been working so far since 2013 in order to bring coding and computational thinking to schools in Europe. You will find here the listed of ambassadors sorted by country. So I'm based in Brussels, in Belgium, so I get the ambassadors from Belgium. You will have some information from them also below, and then you also have the possibility to join them, to contact them in case you have any question or any doubt. You will be able to do so via email, via Twitter, or also with a website. So when it comes to the resources, if you click there, you will see that they are sorted in a way that you can either choose if you want to learn, if you want to teach, or if you want to explore the presentations and toolkit. So let's say you're a teacher, which I hope you are, and that you want to, you're trying to find something to do with your students, to replicate with your students. So in this case, you will need to select the Teach tab. And here you will be able to find many different and very interesting resources, either the learning bits that we will talk about a bit later on, but also many other resources that are probably, or at least that we hope, are useful for you in the classroom. So next to the resources, you will find the schools, the website for schools that we have recently produced and created for you, for teachers like you, in order to help you get started with coding and computational thinking, and that we hope you really find interesting. So in this, if you click in this tab, you will find three different options. So you will find the Why, Training, and Code Week for All, which is the Code Week for All Challenge. This is something that we will focus on in a different video, but in this case, what we're going to do, what we're going to explore together, is the Training tab. So once in the training website, you will be able to see and to find, to explore 8 different learning bits, what we call a learning bit, which actually are free training materials designed for teachers like you from many different subjects. So you don't have to be a computer science teacher in order to take these learning bits in order to use them. So you can be either a teacher of music, math, languages, no matter the subject you teach, you will be able to use those. And also you don't have to be experienced on coding. So if you don't have any idea about coding, if you have never thought about bringing coding to your classroom, this is also fine. This is designed for teachers with no experience at all. So we're trying to serve all teachers here. And see here in this website, there are many areas or themes, whatever you want to call them. So we have coding without digital technology, computational thinking and problem solving, visual programming introduction to Scratch, creating educational games with Scratch, making robotics thinking in the classroom, developing creativity thinking through mobile app development, thinking and making, and also coding for all subjects, which we hope it's very relevant for you, especially if you're not a computer science teacher. But how does a learning bit look like? So let's click on one of those. Let's choose, for instance, making robotics and tinkering from Tulia. And when you click here, when you click in the learning bit, you will be able to see the same structure for all of them. So all the learning bits follow the same structure. So we hope it's something really easy also for you to follow. The very beginning, you will find here a very short introduction about the topic. In this case is making robotics and tinkering in the classroom. Right after the introduction, you will be able to see a short video also done by Tulia, by the expert in this case, where in this case she's explaining us, she's trying to tell us how to build a robotic hand. So something really nice and quick that we really encourage you to watch, to look at. After the video, and if you scroll down, you can also download the script of the video, and right below the script you can download the different lesson plans that the expert, which is Tulia in this case, has produced for you, for teachers like you to use with your students. So you will find one lesson plan devoted for primary school, second lesson plan for lower secondary school, and a third one for upper secondary school. And if you click in any of those, you will be able to see to download your lesson plan. And when you open the lesson plan, you will find a Word document with all the needed information for you to start doing the same activity with your students. So this is very easy and no time consuming. You just need to select one topic, download one lesson plan according to the age of your students, and all the information needed is here. So you can see here, for instance, the duration, the estimated duration of the activity, the age level, so what are the students that you can bring this activity for, the learning objectives, skills and competences, the activities and roles, so what does it happen in the activity and how. You can also see, well, you have here a few pictures, you also have the materials needed, what do you need in order to make this possible, in order to make this happen, where the activity is taking place, also a description of the activity, again with some pictures and with a step-by-step process, in this case to build a robotic hand, so something really easy and we hope also inspirational for you. After the description, you will also find the name of the author, so in case you want to contact the expert you know who have created this this material, this resource. So again, something very easy. We hope that it doesn't take that much time, especially for teachers with no experience on coding. You just need to select one topic of the learning bits, then select the lesson plan depending on the age of your students and replicate it with your students. You can just copy paste information or modify according to your students and also according to your needs. But what if you don't want to teach computer science, or if you're not a STEM teacher? What happens in this case? Well, you still have the chance to participate in Code Week by having a look at the last learning bit that we have produced, and in this case it's called Coding for All Subjects. We click here, and in this learning bit, different teachers from different countries who are teaching actually science, STEM, music, or foreign languages explain how easy it is to integrate coding in their lesson, in their classroom. And they also provide you with different lesson plans ready to use that you can also download and do the same with your students. So in this case, instead of having one lesson plan for different age groups, you will find only one lesson plan per lesson. So you will have the first lesson plan for tinkering and making with Makey Makey that the teachers Isabel and Concepcion have done for you. You will have the lesson plan if you're a teacher of music. This is a very good option for you. This is a lesson plan that Elizabeth and Annie has produced for you. You also have a third lesson plan that deals with robotics and inclusion for primary in STEM. This is a lesson plan that the teacher Deborah Carmela has also produced, and where the B-bots, these very nice small robots, are introduced in the classroom especially for young kids. The last lesson plan, it's a daily life algorithm for a clean lesson, and this has been done by Stefania Altieri from Italy. So really very nice lesson plans that we hope that all teachers can replicate in the classroom if, of course, the topic fits your subject. So if you're their music teacher, a languages teacher, STEM teacher, or even if you want to teach robotics and inclusion, why not? So make sure you browse the CodeWeek website of schools. There are plenty resources and learning bits waiting for you. Also make sure you check the videos on each learning bit, which we hope it's really interesting and meaningful for you. They're very nice done by great experts on the topic. And something also that is very relevant to share, that I would like to share with you, is that if English is not your preferred language, you can also select any other language from this drop down menu here. So let's say you're coming from Finland, you want to find your video with Finnish subtitles, then in this case you will be able to do so. This is something that we have done because we think it's really important to reach as many teachers as possible, and while we cannot produce and record the same video in the different languages, we can provide you with subtitles in different languages. So we hope you appreciate that, and that it's also very relevant and interesting for you as well. And something that is also really worth mentioning is the fact that the website, together with the different learning bits, is translated into 29 different languages. So if you're French, for instance, and if you're not very familiar with English, or your preferred language is English, you can just go to the French tab, and here in this drop-down menu, you will be able to select Formation. And here you will see all the different information in French, even in the learning bits. When you click in the learning bit, the information is in French. And the same for the lesson plan, which we think is one of the most important things. So you know for sure that regardless the language that you speak, you will be able to find three different lesson plans that are actually translated into 29 different languages. So we hope it's really useful for you, and that it can help you out to get started in your code week. So now that you know how easy it is to take part in your code week, why not start it now? Browse the learning bits. Please try to find a topic that your students would enjoy very much. Select one of the lesson plans available in the website. Remember, they're available in different languages as well. And when the day comes, just replicate it with your students. Remember always to report back. It's very important that you report back your activity after the day has passed if you want to get the certificate validated by the European Commission. And next to the school tabs, you will be able to find the About page. Here you will find many different things, much more information about the initiative. So the what for schools, why coding, code week in numbers. This is also very interesting in order to see the impact of the campaign since the very beginning. So as you can see here, 2014 participation was not that that much. Now in 2018 it has really grown a lot. So this is also thanks to you, and we can only rely on you to keep on growing, so that this number keeps growing much more in 2019, also in the following years. So please feel free to browse the website, give it a try, and make sure you participate in EU Code Week 2019 and the years to come. And next to the About page, you will see the blog. Here you will be able to see different blog posts showcasing different activities run by teachers like you, that we hope it can be used in a way to inspire you to, in order to create your future activity. Maybe feel free to have a look at the activities. There are also news and many other things that might be useful for you. So make sure also to have a look at the blog. And something very important, please also stay tuned to social media channels such as the Facebook group for teachers that we have created, where we always publish different opportunities for teachers, where all teachers also share their ideas to get engaged in Code Week. So maybe you want to explore those and see if maybe you can develop something similar, maybe join also an existing activity. So stay tuned to the group. We already have almost 4,000 members, so this is very good. Thank you so much to all of you who are already there, and if you're not there, make sure you register soon, that you join the group of Facebook soon. Also in Twitter you can find many different things for Code Week. If you go to the account Code Week EU, you will be able to see also here different news. Sometimes also we publish also tools, maybe also resources that might be relevant for you, and especially everything that we consider that you can use in the classroom that might also be relevant for you. So also make sure you follow us on Twitter, and of course spread the word and share in your social media channels with your network, within your colleagues. So now that we have explored a bit the website of schools, we hope that you're more confident, that you feel more motivated in order to start registering an activity in Code Week. As we said, it's really easy to get started. You don't need any previous experience on coding. You don't have to be a computer science teacher. So no matter the subject you teach, you can always get started in EU Code Week. This is why we're here. In order to help you out, to get started, to support you. So make sure you check the lesson plans and all the different resources that you will find in the website for you. Something very important to have in mind as well is that Code Week is not only happening in October. Of course, you can register an activity in participating in the peak of the campaign, which is in October, but this is not the only time of the year that you can bring code into your classroom and participate in Code Week. So you can either do it during the summer, after the peak of the campaign, after October, and also the beginning of the year. So there is always a perfect time for you to bring code into your classroom, and most important, for you to bring fun to your students, which at the end I think is the most important thing. So thank you so much to everybody for being there, for making Code Week possible and also a reality, and we're looking forward to seeing many more activities in the map this year. So thank